Alright guys, so it's a new season of Devil's Altar. And first of all, I'm gonna clear the missing two stages that don't get auto-cleared. And second of all, I will explain why I think it's really important to make this every single time. And really, you guys don't have an excuse after auto-clearing was invented. You don't have an excuse not to even do it just once in a month. Or whatever the time is that you need to do it in. I could have cleared this without going to the next phase, but I was lazy. And I was lazy because I'm lagging while I'm recording. That's the last boss. As you see, I'm not doing everything on 5 stars. This is way too exhausting. Like it would take way too much time. And doing it on a comfortable level, but for doing it on a comfortable level, you do it every time. That's better than doing it uncomfortably and maybe once every other season. This is really heavily just BR gated, and it's not worth the stress if you don't have the necessary BR. So transformation bonus would be the next best. So you're running this setup every time: attack, awakening, transformation. While awakening transformation not here, I'm running attack, defensive conversion. And then I'm running attack, awakening, defensive conversion, and then I'm running attack, awakening and transformation boost. Transformation boost gonna give damage to transformation at maximum rank. Awakening boost is stunning the target and giving additional damage. And attack boost is just giving, well, attack and damage. Try to get to 55 stars. If that's not possible for you at the beginning, it's not a problem at all. You may get to 50. But in the end, you want to reach the highest. I didn't open any chests of the season yet, and you see this is a lot of resources. I'm opening all now. This is a lot of pearls. There can also be gold pearls dropped. And then you can also get the tiers. I think doing this is very important for the rebirth tab, not really for the normal tab. If you need to upgrade the normal tab still, I would recommend actually doing the lower version of Altar. For example, if you didn't, I don't know how this was possible to not be done with the normal pearls actually. I'm just buying any at this point because I need to collect the red pearls, as you know. But as you see, there is attack, 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 attack. So this is 4. And I think you can max them to like level 60 or something. I was asking in the Discord, but no one was answering, so I don't know. But this is a lot. This is really a lot. It may be 300 per slot, maybe. But you get bonus. And you also get attack from here. So I think maybe you can get like 10,000 attack from all these pages maxed. And this is, I don't know. There's not many places where else you will get so much. So I recommend you to do this. To do the altar. If you don't have enough spirit beads, you can buy them with shells, or you can, as I said, do the first altar instead. This is really expensive to upgrade red pearls. As you see, I don't have my beds upgraded at all. That's why I don't have many of the tabs unlocked. But this will be happening soon. As I already mentioned, I am focusing now on upgrading my Ella pearls and other pearls as well. Gut. Also you can accumulate Stones of Time doing this. And if you didn't upgrade everything yet, then once you unlock it, you will be able to upgrade it right away. Okay, that's everything I have to say, guys. I think this is a very important feature, even if you're a priest, guys. Just get through the hustle once in a month. If you're serious about the game, you're gonna do it. And with a wind proc, you can also deal decent damage with a priest. So. Have a good day. This should be the last video I will record now. Already recorded two videos before that, and it's everything I wanted to say. See you!